Hey guys, it's Josh here at Modern Frontiersman. And today, due to a request, we are going to talk about some considerations for homestead security. Now, before we get going on this, the first thing I want to say, and I've said it before in past videos, is where do you live? Your location is extremely important. I think the first step that we need to take towards making sure our families are safe is taking into consideration where we live. It would be best to live in a place where we don't have to deal with as many security threats as other places. So, you know, if you live in a big city, compared to out here, you're going to have a lot more possible threats than if you were, you know, to live in a location like this. So I understand, you know, I get it that people, you know, I can't leave here on my job, this and this and that. But what I would ask is how important is your security to you and your family? And I would encourage you to do everything in your power to get in a safer environment if you're not already in one. Now, one thing we need to take into account outside of our location, which we need to think of first, is our terrain. There is an acronym in the military. It's COCOA, COCO, however you want to say it. We're not going to get too far into that, but I'm taking that into account when I'm telling you these things. We're going to get further into that in a future video when we talk about some more hardened defenses when we're referring to like a without rule of law situation. This is for, you know, times are good right now. We're not going to dig too deep into this, but it's just terrain, about terrain appreciation, basically understanding your terrain, seeing what kind of key features you have that could work for you or against you. Do you have places where your enemies could hide, say behind these trees or stuff like that, if somebody's coming up to your homestead? One big thing is are you uphill or downhill? You know, we're downhill. The road is actually up there on the other side of these woods here. We're actually downhill from where people will likely come from. That could be a good thing. I'm not going to show you like the house and how our house is actually sitting on the land, but I've determined how I can actually use that to my advantage if I started to harden my defenses. You know, that's something to think about, is your terrain, how is the land laid, and most likely avenues of approach. Now, a point in that acronym that I mentioned is avenues of approach. Keep an eye on your likely avenues of approach. And I'd be willing to bet that, like us, your most likely avenue of approach for a bad guy coming up on your land and your homestead is your driveway. One thing we've considered is putting up a gate here. Yes, that's not going to stop people from getting out and walking around, but it will be a deterrent, and it will keep them from getting up here and, say, stealing something large like a lawnmower or something like that, something they'd need to pull their truck up to, because they're not going to get anything up this hill. There's a hill here. They're not going to get anything up and around that. It's steeper and a little bit taller than it looks here on the camera. So, you know, our driveway's kind of in a rut, you know, and the land's higher on each side. So I think a gate or something like that would definitely be a good deterrent and keep people from getting out. People are always going to take the path of least resistance, and bad guys and thieves are lazy. They're going to take the low-hanging fruit. They're not going to risk confrontation or getting shot in most normal circumstances, which is what we're talking about right now. Now, you probably can't see it from here, but when we first moved onto this land, there was right here, this area was cleared out. It's all grown up now, but what it looked to be like a four-wheeler trail or something coming out of the woods behind our house up to our land. At that time, I didn't know who lived back here. I didn't know why they could be coming up here, why there was a trail coming up here. So as we were clearing off this land, nobody had lived here in a very long time. So we had a lot of work to do, and we still do. But as we were clearing brush and limbs and things like that up out of the yard, and you know, up in the woods and stuff, I've piled all those logs and all those branches up here so a four-wheeler couldn't get any closer, once again, in case somebody wanted to come up here and steal something or cause mischief, they'd be less likely
to get off of it and come up here on foot to mess with us. Fortunately, we've met these people now, and the people who live behind us back in the woods here, really nice, really good people. So we're not worried about that so much anymore, but it is still piled up there. So that's something to consider. Maybe if you if you're cutting down trees or anything, you know, that you're gonna that you don't want there, maybe you could pile it up in an avenue of approach that you don't use. Say maybe you had an old road coming through into the back of your land or something like that. You might could pile that stuff up there to create a barrier so they can't get vehicles up any closer. Or, you know, it might make a lot of noise if they tried to get through there, and you might be more likely to hear them or see them coming.
Now, security cameras are a great option. Some people argue that even if you just have signs that say there are security cameras is a good deterrent, and it may be, but actually having them is even better. We do have cameras. They are surrounding our land. That camera looks at the driveway. So if somebody does get past that, I can still see them here at the front door. And another thing that you can get, you know, an alarm system. If you can't afford a big alarm system that's hooked up to the grid and all that, that's no problem. I don't think you really necessarily need one. You know, you can get those little ones with the little magnets on them that they sell them at Harbor Freight and Dollar General and stuff as well. They're like a dollar. You put them on all your windows, all of our doors. We do have those on our doors and windows, as well as an actual alarm system, because, you know, when that thing comes open, that thing starts making all that racket, they're likely going to run off, and it's going to alert us, and we're going to know that they're here, and they're going to get blasted back out the door. Now, lights. We have these solar powered lights all over the place. They're on the front of the house, they're on my shed back here. You know, somebody walks in front of them, you know, they're motion sensored. They're great. They don't cost that much. They're solar powered, so they're not hooked to the grid. I got solar panels down here that are running all the power in my shed and everything anyway. So, you know, it's not costing me anything to have these things hooked up. You know, people start moving around and lights start coming on, you know, they're likely going to run away. You know, they don't want to be seen. They don't want to be caught. So have lights, you know, with motion detectors that can come on and scare the bad guys off. Keep all your stuff locked up in a shed or something, and don't let everybody know everything that you have. That's just a very basic thing, you know. Keep your stuff put up, keep your stuff private, and keep your shed or wherever you keep this stuff locked. What if you need to escape your house for some reason? Do you have a back door or an alternate way out of your land other than the driveway in case you need to get away from some bad guys or something like that? Or there's a fire and you can't get out the front door. If not, you might want to consider putting in a back door or having another road or another driveway or a trail out the back of your land where you can escape if you need to. Now, we also have another road that comes onto our land. Most people don't know that this is even here, and that's good. That's how I want it. But at the end of this road, near the main road, I let it grow up. So when you're driving by on the main road, you can't even tell that this is here. You drive right by it and never see it unless you were really looking hard for it. So I let, you know, at the edge of the road where this road starts, at the edge of the main road, I let that grass grow up and conceal this area. You know, hopefully y'all know the difference in cover and concealment. But you know, I don't necessarily need like hard cover. If things can just be concealed and people don't know it's there in the first place, then hey, that's great. Now, of course, and obviously, you might want to consider fencing your land in. We're going to do that eventually, but you know, that's expensive. And we just don't have the money for that right now. And fortunately, we live in a place where I'm not too hard pressed to get that done, because we just don't have people coming down here. It's very unlikely at this point in time for somebody to come down here and mess with us. We've never had anything stolen. We did have some strange people coming up in our yard when we first moved in, but I think we've pretty much gotten rid of them. Now, we did have a guy that lives way up the hill from us, way up on top of out of this holler, that has come down here and started crap a few times. We'd never even met him before. He's definitely off his rocker. But he come down here one day when we hadn't been here just a couple years, and just popped up one day and started cussing me out, followed me home at night,
And I jumped out with the light and, you know, shined it on him and rushed up on him. And he kind of got, I kind of scared him. But then he eventually left. I scared him off, but he was accusing me of trespassing on his land and trapping on his land. I don't trespass on people's land. I definitely don't trap on people's land. He's just crazy. But we haven't had any major issues out of him. But we did let everybody know, just kind of casually tell people that he had been coming down here starting trouble. So if anything were to ever occur, people would know, hey, you know, this, there has been an issue with him before. You know, I'd have people that could back me up on that and know that there were problems and he had been coming down here starting stuff. Now, if you have that kind of situation, you should probably call the police. I didn't, because I thought it'd be just better to not escalate the situation, and I can usually talk him down. I can usually run him off. He's one of those people, you stand up to him and just stay calm and show a command presence, they go away. Eventually we will put up fences, privacy fences and stuff like that, and that's definitely something that you might want to consider. Now this is Bruno. He's a German Shepherd and Australian Shepherd mix. He's a really good guard dog. He gets really aggressive when people pull up in our driveway. He's never bit anybody, but he barks like crazy, and he will go after people. He does get very aggressive. He's never bitten anybody, but I don't know that he wouldn't. And fortunately, I'm usually about the only person he will listen to. He's a really good dog. He protects the kids. He keeps an eye on them, stays right next to them when they are outside playing. And he's just a great guard dog. He definitely lets us know if he sees anybody. We have some people occasionally walk down the road, which is odd out here. But if he sees them, we know they're there. If somebody pulls up in this yard, we know they're there. He's in this pen right now because I expect some deliveries coming in the morning. And he will attack the UPS man. He's got after him before, and he's tried to tear him up. But he's a good dog. So you can definitely get a dog. Dogs are a great deterrent. I think he's really helped keep the crazy man up the hill away, because that guy's scared of dogs, and he's definitely scared of this dog because, you know, he's all loving right now. But if he don't know you and you pull up, he'll get after you. Another thing to consider, maybe you could get some guineas or turkeys or something like that that'll also make a whole lot of noise if there's any commotion or anybody coming up.
Now, of course, your last resort is your firearms. If somebody comes into your house at night or something like that and you have to shoot them, that's an unfortunate event. Hopefully it won't come to that. And that's the point, is that, you know, we want to deter people and try to keep them from getting that close and coming up in your house in the first place. Nobody wants that to happen. And be quite honest, if you do want that to happen, if you want someone to break in your house with you and your family so you can shoot them, I want you to unsubscribe from my channel right now, because I don't want people like you here. But I know most of you are not those people. We want to keep the bad guys and the trouble away from us. So I think it's definitely most important to get to a safe location where you want to live and raise your family, where things are less likely to happen. And that's not in a city, because your population density is all messed up. The more people there are, the higher chances of you having to deal with somebody. This is definitely not an exhaustive list of homestead security topics. We're going to go further into this in the future video. Like I said, that'll be a very long video, but I think y'all will enjoy it. That's my thing. Just keep people away from the house and try to scare people off from the get-go so you don't got to deal with them. So in the future, I have a class coming out. It's going to be an online class, which will be a basic SHTF rifleman course. This is the first time I'm really making it public. It'll be available to my patrons first. They will get it for free. If you would like to subscribe there, that is actually the best way to support this channel and Fortner's Frontier Leather, is at patreon.com/Fortner's Frontier Leather. And this rifleman class will be available to all the $10 a month and up tiers. You can join for as little as $1 a month, but the $10 a month tier will get this class for free and not have to pay any extra for it. But basically in this class, I'll be teaching defenses like this. That'll be one of the aspects of the class, will be defending your homestead, because that's the whole point of it, is for us to defend our communities, defend our land, and defend our families. That will be the point of that class. So we really go into depth on all the acronyms and all the different military principles for defense and basically being a rifleman and doing that kind of job in SHTF. So I hope you'll join over there at Patreon, and I hope you'll be interested in that class. But I hope this maybe just gives you some basic ideas or things to possibly take into consideration. I'm not here in most of these videos to tell you what to do. I'm just telling you the thoughts that I've had, things that I'm doing, and in hopes that it will help you out in some way, or maybe even make you think of something better to do. So thank you for joining. Please be sure to hit subscribe and hit the like button and share this video with your friends. For anybody who may be new to prepping, or new to self-reliance, new to homesteading and that kind of thing, please share these videos with these people. I definitely want this content to make sense to new preppers and people that don't know a whole lot about this stuff. So I try to word things in a way that's not too jargony, and most everybody will understand. It's hard for me. I'm sorry if I do a lot of ums and I get tripped up. It's because I'm trying to think of how to word this in a way that everybody will understand it, and not just Marines. So thanks for tuning in. I'll see you next time. Stay self-reliant.